scientists. Welcome back to the Science Studio. Today, I'm working on a new painting of an outdoor scene. It has trees, a river, and even a few mountains. But something doesn't look quite right. It all looks a little flat, doesn't it? I want this picture to look more realistic. But right now, it looks more like it's just stuck on the paper. What do you think could be missing? Oh, maybe it's something to do with how things feel. But how can I make something feel different in a picture? Let's see if we can figure this out together. Look over here on my table. I have a few different materials that I was thinking of using in my art. Maybe they can help me figure out what's missing. Let's see. This cotton ball feels really soft when I touch it. And this cardboard? Wow, it's so bumpy and a little rough. This fabric here is very smooth. Wait a minute. These different feelings, they're called textures. That's what my painting is missing. It needs texture to make it feel more real. Texture is all about how something feels when you touch it. It can be soft, rough, smooth, bumpy, and so much more. But you know what's really cool? We can also see texture even if we can't touch it. When you look at this fluffy cotton candy, you can almost imagine how soft it would feel, right? That's because our eyes can help us guess the texture of things just by looking at them. Back to these materials on my table. This one feels sort of rough, like the bark on a tree. And this cotton ball is so soft and light. Imagine if we used these textures in our art. How do you think that would change the way it looks? This cardboard is bumpy and rough, kind of like the bark on a tree. If we use this in our painting and make it a collage, we can make the tree look rough and real. Then it would feel more like a real tree too. Look at that! Now the tree has texture. It looks like it's popping off the page. Next, let's use this piece of fabric. It feels smooth and gentle, just like the water in the painting. We can replace the water with this fabric to give our painting another interesting texture. Now the lake looks like it's filled with calm, smooth water. Now I want to show the texture of the clouds. What material could I add to this painting to make them look soft and fluffy? Take a moment to pause the video while you think about it. I'll be here to talk about how we can use them when you're ready. Yeah, we can use the cotton balls to give the clouds and our painting a light, fluffy texture. See how the cotton creates a fluffy look? It's perfect for showing how the clouds really look when we see them in the sky. Adding these different materials to our painting makes everything look more real and interesting, doesn't it? It's like the picture has come to life. Now it's your turn, scientist. I want you to think about how you can use different materials or drawing techniques to add texture to your own artwork. Open up your science sketchbook and draw a picture of something you love. Maybe it's a park, your favorite animal, or even a fun day at the beach. as you draw, think about how you can show different textures. Could you use a crayon to make something look rough? Maybe you can use different materials like we did. Use your imagination and the materials around you to bring your picture to life with texture. And thank you for helping me bring my artwork to life today, scientist. I had so much fun exploring textures with you. Until next time, keep creating, and I'll see you in the science studio. Hey, hey.